Hello and welcome to this video tutorial from Computergaga.com. And in this video, we are going to look at Microsoft Flow. What is it and why should you be interested? Well, Microsoft Flow is a way of automating day-to-day tasks, and there are absolutely loads of examples where it can come in useful to you. Now you can see the URL at the top of my screen. I'll put that in the description of this video as well. But you could also just pop to Google, type Microsoft Flow, and get access nice and quick from there. As long as you have a Microsoft account or an Office 365 subscription, you will be able to use Microsoft Flow. Now let's have a quick look at some examples of why it can be useful. You can see I have this menu on the left-hand side with different ways of creating flows and managing your flows. I'm not going to get too in-depth with it in this video. I want to keep it short, simple, see an example. If I do scroll down this page, this home page, you can see they provide lots of information about what Flow is and how you can use it. Now for a really good example of what Flow is capable of, I'm going to click on the connectors on the left hand side and see what other software or websites or accounts you could use Flow to improve your day-to-day productivity. Flow is typically used to do things like manage your emails, receive notifications, or data collection for classic uses. And just look down here. We have some OneDrive, we have Twitter, we have Outlook, Power BI, and the list goes on and on. I'm only just reaching the B's and the C's now. All these popular services that Flow can help automate typical tasks in. We have Instagram in here, LinkedIn, and it's definitely worth you checking out in your own time. Now you notice some of these connectors say premium underneath. There are different memberships that you can get with Flow. And this is what, at the time of doing this video, is currently an offer. So as long as you have a Microsoft account or an Office 365 subscription, you can sign in right now and have Flow for free. And you are just limited to 750 runs a month. Remember, you can get automated flows or ones where you just press a button. So automated can rack up those runs pretty quick, depending what they're doing. But you have unlimited flow creation and it checks every 15 minutes for a refresh. Whereas Flow Plan 1, you get a lot more runs and a lot more regular checks. And then Flow Plan 2, yeah, even more. So you have to pay for a little bit extra, but Flow is free if you just want to use it for a few automated processes to be noted about things that are important to you or handle emails that are important to you and you may receive regularly. Now, for example of using Flow, I'm going to click on the templates option on the left because we can create our own flows and piece them together, and they can be very in depth if you wanted to be. I don't want this video to be really in depth. I'm trying to keep it short and sweet, but at the same time informative and useful. And Flow provide loads of templates for what they think is going to be useful. And I can scroll through or use the links at the top to find what I want. Now I'm going to type in Excel and Dropbox because for a pretend scenario, I want to imagine that I receive timesheets maybe weekly, and they get saved into a folder on Dropbox. And what I would like is for it to update Excel every time a file was put into that folder. So a new row is added, and I can see that someone has saved their timesheet in there. And I could even do some analysis on that if I wanted to, like how many times was so-and-so late in filing their timesheet. That could be done because I'd have the data. Now I'm going to run this, and here's the one I want. Insert a row in Excel when a file was created in a specified folder of Dropbox. I'm going to give it a click. And this will take me to the next step where it explains itself a little bit more. And notice it towards the bottom mentions the Excel spreadsheet must have the columns name and date. So they're telling you that they're going to insert the row in Excel. If you can use those column headers, then everything will be all right. Let's have a look at my Excel spreadsheet. So this is what I have. I have this file called Timesheet Tracker, which is saved onto my OneDrive. And I have the column headers date and name as they asked me to. And if I click on the Design tab at the top, this is in a table and the table is called Tracker. And I'm mentioning this because Flow is going to ask me for this information shortly. Now let's go back to Flow. Now this also syncs in with Dropbox, and you can see at the bottom that this Flow is already connected to one of my Dropbox accounts and also to Excel. Now you may need to perform that connection the first time that you use one of these services, whatever it be, whether it be Aweber, whether it be Twitter, whether it be Power BI. You'll have to sign in that first time and it should remember it. You can see those lovely green ticks next to what I have. Now, I also have my Dropbox open at the moment, just to show what I have. And here it is. I have a folder called Timesheets, and it's currently empty. We're going to set up this Flow, and then we're going to see that in action. Back to Flow again, and let's continue. So here we go. Dropbox question, when a file is created in what folder? Now I'm going to click on this little folder button on the end and just navigate through my Dropbox to choose that timesheets folder that I mentioned just a moment ago. Now sometimes, depending what the trigger is and what the actions are, you do get some advanced options. If I clicked on that, it's mentioned about some kind of infer content type, but this list will change depending what your service is, what the trigger is, what the actions are. I'm going to hide that for now. It's not anything I'm interested in. And then over to Excel. They want to know the file name and the table name. So the file name, let's navigate to it. It's on my OneDrive. And here we go. Timesheet Tracker. I'm going to select that. And then the table name is Tracker. This will list the tables in that file. I only have the one which we know is called Tracker. It then comes up and we've got the date and the name column headers that they said that I need to use. And I've put whatever code they need to put in there for this to work. Now I could create additional steps if I wanted to. Maybe I want some other kind of action or something to happen in addition to what's going on at the moment. But I'm just going to click on save. That's going to save this flow. I can see it says saved at the top. So then I can jump across to my flows. And there it is. Modified 9 seconds ago. It's an automated flow. I won't have to update this myself. And it tells me what it does. If I click inside of this flow, a bit more information about it as to what it's set up, what connections it's using. And then at the bottom, a run history. At the moment, no history. So let's put a file in Dropbox and see this happen. So I have just added a timesheet into the Dropbox folder. There it is, called Joe Allen. Added 15 seconds ago. Now remember, these automated flows are going to update themselves every 15 minutes. So we may not see an action immediately, but this is going to automatically update itself within 15 minutes. Let's go and check out the spreadsheet to see if there's been an update. Okay, so here we are back in the timesheet tracker spreadsheet. And you can see that the information from the Joe Allen file has appeared in our spreadsheet automatically. We have the date, the 16th of September. We also have a time in there of 6:48. And we have the name of the file and this Power Apps ID. Now, the date doesn't look too pretty at the moment, so I just wanted to take this video one step further, because that's what we do, and look at creating a query to tidy this information up. I'm going to click inside my table, click on data, and from table slash range, this is going to open it up in the Power Query editor. We're not going to spend too long here, don't worry, but now the date looks beautiful. And I'm going to remove the Power Apps ID column. Not interested in that. And with the name, it's pretty much there. Let's imagine that we have a template that these people are filling in, and they've always got their name at the top. So I could go to the extent of splitting this column, maybe by a delimiter. And that delimiter will be the period, the full stop from the rightmost delimiter. Click OK. Going through this reasonably quickly because this is not a Power Query tutorial. I have others on that. I'm then going to remove this. Imagine that I don't need that column. And then I'm going to replace values and replace the hyphen with a space. Click OK. And that tidies up their name. Maybe one last step, I could go to transform and format to capitalize each word. And then I can load this back in. Home, close and load. Close and load two. And now I'm going to load it into a new table on a new worksheet. Let's put it on an existing worksheet. Let's put it next to the one I have. I know that's going to be three columns. I know that because Flow is bringing it in. And the query will come in, and here it is. So Flow will bring in that data into columns A, B, C automatically as files are added into Dropbox. And I've just done a little tidy up so that the data in columns E and F we can use for our analysis. You know, how many people fold their timesheets on time, etc. Now, the one last thing I want to do in this video is go back to Flow. And in Flow, I'm going to click on My Flows, where we will see the one that we set up. We can come into the flow, and you can see the run history. That at 7:48, 9 minutes ago apparently, there was a successful run. And you'll see those runs appear. Remember, it checks every 15 minutes on a free plan, and we'll automatically do that and run if it needs to run. You get 750 runs a month. So that is our video on a quick introduction to Microsoft Flow. It's definitely worth exploring. There are tons of connectors, most of them free. Some of them, like Aweber and Salesforce, will be premium ones. But it's definitely worth checking out to see how you can speed up your productivity day-to-day by automating mundane admin processes. I hope you found this video useful. Please check out some of our other videos on our YouTube channel and come check us out at computergaga.com.